Dit is SBS Dutch.
Hoe kwam je er nou op als tweede generatie om een Nederlandse winkel te beginnen?
Well, I just missed all the Dutch food in Australia. And there used to be a Dutch store in Adelaide, but that closed down. So we thought we wanted to open up another Dutch store where people could come and enjoy the gezelligheid.
You're a typical second-gen Dutchie because you understand what I ask you in Dutch, but you answer in English.
Yes, that's how we grew up. My mum and dad would speak to us in Dutch and we would answer in English. And in the end, they would speak half Dutch, half English. So that's really our language is half Dutch, half English.
You say I missed the Dutch stuff, but you were born here. How does that go?
Well, my mum and dad took us nearly every year we went back to Holland. We had family come from Holland, so they're always bringing all the beautiful Dutch foods. And mum only cooked Dutch food growing up, and she let all my kids eat Dutch food. So that's mainly what I still cook now for my family as well.
Aardappel, groente, vlees.
Yeah, stamppot.
And how did your parents react when you said, oh, I'm going to open a Dutch shop?
Well, my mum's already had passed away, so that was a little bit sad for me. But, yeah, my dad was really excited, and my uncle was very excited because he's a retired Dutch baker. So he was ready to step in and help me straight away with learning how to make beautiful Dutch cakes.
It's not just a shop. Like you said, you're selling cakes. It looks amazing with the Amsterdamse Gracht on the wall. What kind of visitors do you get? Are they mainly Dutch or is it whoever wants to come and grace for deep fried food and beautiful cakes?
In the beginning, it was mainly the Dutch families coming in. But slowly now we're getting all the locals coming in. Lots of different clubs are coming in to come and enjoy the Dutch food and look at all the shop and everything and try different biscuits. And now all the younger generation are starting to come as well, all the younger families that had omas and opas.
Well, that's good to hear because that's an issue, right, around the country with the Dutch clubs. It's the older generation who are visiting the club, but the younger generations, it's hard to get them in.
Yeah, it is. It's hard to get them in. You have to sort of bring the interest of the younger ones in here with just opening up to them and speaking and making sure they feel welcome and be as friendly as you can.
What's your secret then? Just that? So simple? Be friendly?
I think so, yeah. Just try and put on a bit of the Aussie as well as the Dutch and a mishmash because that's what we really are growing up. So, yeah, and keeping family involved in it, making everyone feel welcome.
Now, I'm based in Sydney. I'm here for the weekend in Adelaide, and I have been checking out your socials for a long time, and I'm always seeing the amazing cakes that you are baking, and you learn it from your mum's uncle.
Yeah, I do. I think I've been doing it with him for, I think, 2 or 3 years now. But, yeah, he teaches me every time. I don't listen sometimes, but I love working with him. I'm always learning from him.
So you're third gen, right? I'm still counting correctly. Third generation. How Dutch do you feel?
I feel really Dutch working here. I feel more Dutch Aussie. I love working here, yeah, because I learn from all the customers that come in and like they tell me all their stuff that they had when they were younger. So, yeah.
Just let the listeners like make their mouth water. What kind of cakes do you make?
Oh, I make the tompoes. What else do I make? Moorkop, apple tart, apple strudel. We do a speculaas cheesecake, which is really popular. Gevulde speculaas. Yeah, that's really popular as well. Boterkoek. We make poffertjes here.
Recently, you tried out rijstevlaai?
Oh, yeah, I did rijstevlaai on Thursday. That was really interesting because I've never made that with him before. So I didn't realise that's got yeast in the bottom. So it was really cool, yeah.
Not really great. I think if you bake all these things and try it out, you have to taste it.
Yeah, no, it's not very nice to me. It's not very kind, but, you know, makes my days very happy here.
What is your bestseller?
Tompoes, definitely. I think we make a batch of those just about every day, and there's 16 in a batch. So they're very popular. They usually sell out before we close in the kitchen. So, yeah.
Does this mean also that the future of the Dutch pantry is secured with you involved?
I hope so. I'm definitely proud to work with Mum. She's taught me so much in business. I've been working with her since I was 10 years old, so about 14 years I've been working with Mum. A lot of hard times with her, but we're really good at fighting now. We know how to resolve it.
The Dutch way?
Yeah, the Dutch way. Loud.
Is Opa still around?
Yes, Opa still comes around.
He must be proud that his granddaughter is now involved.
Yeah, he is. He really loves it as well. He loves coming here and enjoying everything with Annalise, and she makes him coffee and croquettes and stuff.
Yeah, that's probably the main thing the Dutchies come for, right? Bitterballen, croquette, frikandel special.
Rookworst is really popular here as well. They love the, we do the Limburg feast, it's the roll with rookworst, sauerkraut, crispy onion, mustard, and then chips. That's yummy. That's popular here as well.
You said before that you like to also have Dutch people involved working here, but that's not too easy, right?
No, we found it quite difficult to employ Dutch people. We do try and look for backpackers because we like them to come in because they're young and fresh and they're very easy to train. But we also have other nationalities working here at the moment until we can find some more Dutch people.
So everyone who listens and think, oh, I live around Adelaide, walk in and have a chat with Angela or Annalise.
Yeah, definitely come in and see us. And we've always got some job to offer, whether it's weekends or during school holidays or any of the young ones. Like, we love the young ones coming in because they're really good at doing dishes and things like that that we don't like doing.
So next big event must be Sinterklaas coming up.
Yes, Sinterklaas, it will be. Yes, on the Saturday. So I think it's on the 7th of December this year. So that'll be pretty busy. Yeah, we'll have oliebollen and all that sort of things as well going.
Do you bake your own pepernoten as well?
Oh my God, no, but I think that would be a really cool adventure to do that. It would be a hard one, a difficult, long journey.
Time consuming, I think. I mean, you know how to make speculaas already. It's just the size.
I know. I think it's sad, though, when you make all those tiny little things and then you see someone just throw a handful in their mouth. It's all that hard work goes to waste.
I thought you were going to say you see them throwing it on the floor, but
My little brother does that on Sinterklaas. He throws it all at all the kids.
Yeah. Oh, that's what you have to do with it. Yeah. Strooigoed. You have to throw it around. Well, thank you so much for your time. It's amazing to taste your tompoes. And it's a really great atmosphere. Thank you and good luck for the future.
Thank you so much, and I hope you come again.
Thank you.
Like, deel, geef je reactie. Volg SBS Dutch op Facebook.